Joe, can you assess, first of all, the play of your offense, especially inside the 30, and what we...
Well, obviously, we couldn't get it. We did a good job most of the day. But both sides of the football and that game, I thought we played a good football game, except the point you're making. We just, it was an execution a couple of times, sometimes we didn't make the selections. And I think you got to give Temple credit. They're quick kids, they're strong. You take a look at them, they're running back kids out there. Tall, crazy kids, they hustle, tackle well. So when they didn't have as much room to protect, they were tough. They were tough to run on, and I didn't particularly throw the ball all the time down in there. Now with the young quarterback, so I think we can do better, no question about that. I'm about to do better down in there. Can't waste that many scoring opportunities in the sense of touchdown and not field goals. But I thought defensively, the offensive guys, tough game. Second half, we had to come out and do some things. They did them. So I was kind of pleased with the whole day.
Joe, just what are the benefits of winning a game like this, the way you won it, having to come back in the fourth quarter and hang in the net?
What's
the benefits of winning the game the way you did?
Of winning it?
Yeah, the way you did.
To win. Well, I thought, no, I think you're underestimating some of these clubs that are so called. You know, this team's on the bus of the game, or team, till this game, Temple. They played UCLA in a bowl game last year, and they lost 21-14. They were a good, solid team, well coached, and I think it was our teams had a hustle second half, had to make some plays, particularly on defense. I think overall it was good for us. I'm just happy we won.
Coach Royster ends up having a big day today. Could you describe what you saw from him? Did you get a feeling this week that he may be able to do something like this today?
Well, I've tried not to look ahead. Said to you as many times, many of you start looking ahead and you're in trouble. So I have not looked at it. I'll go home tonight and look at it. They had a game made and it sounded like somebody told me they were going pretty good. Does anyone know the score?
45-0.
Well, we know what kind of people that we've had trouble with the last couple of years. So I think we'll go home tonight and have the game on tape. Obviously, I told Cohen in the year that they in Ohio State and Alabama, the three teams we had to play on the road, were all really big time football teams. And obviously, Alabama is, I don't know how they made out today, but they played a heck of a first half against us. So I just am going to get forward, get better, and hopefully. A little smarter maybe in some key situations against Iowa and be comfortable playing before a hostile crowd.
Joe, what was your evaluation of Royster's performance? What kind of improvement did you see in the way he was running today? Royster, your evaluation of Royster's running?
Commentary about the kid somewhere earlier, and I think people got the idea that I didn't think he was doing very well. I think I talked to him earlier in the week. I said, forget about what everybody's talking about, just play your game, let's see what happens. And I thought he played very well with it. I thought he made some guys outside of the fumble, which hurt us early in the game. I thought he played very well.
Joe, right here. Your quarterback in the fourth quarter on that 96-yard drive made two big throws on third down while he was getting hit. Could you just talk about maybe the poise and pressure he showed in a big moment?
Well, hopefully he's going to get better over time. And I think something like this is good. He had a big drive, and as you say, he threw a couple of really good passes. And I think he's going to enjoy it a little. I said to him when they were warming up, I said, just forget you're only 12 years old. And I had a picture back on the phone. He said, "I was trying to treat you like you're a baby. You know, you play these. And he's going to be pretty good."
Coach, you got some good plays from Stu Barmati. Did some of the linebackers, do you think, take some steps today?
I thought Sukay and safety made two big time plays. I thought Stu Bar made a big play, something we've been trying to get those guys, because they have athletic ability, and the other kids the same way. So I think in that sense, it was a good game. Because that kid has been, he hadn't thrown an interception. They've been very careful with football. I don't know whether you realize it, but we're very, very good football team today. And they may not be a great team, but they're pretty darn good. Solid, hustle, game off blocks. Offensively, they lose two backs, pretty good, quick. And the quarterback had been good. The wideouts are big kids. Because I thought it was a good idea. And they gave the game, as I said, one end. I thought they had one of the better kicking games I had seen. And I said, "I'm honored in that feeling." So I thought it was a good one. And I think it was good for this. The ball was going to get in there and maybe drive in the cross. Every experience is over.
Joe, Lou Eliadis left the game. Do we have an update on his status? Eliadis?
I think, and I'm only sure he's got a torn ACL. His process of looking at it, he just told me coming in, if you're asked, he said, "I think it's fine." He hadn't had a chance to talk to his coach yet, but he's trying to get a hold of that stock is. That's how it's. I think he's probably out for the year.
Coach, what surprised you about the Temple defense, and why was it so difficult to get to the end zone?